everybody. We're here talking with John Cosmo Cosmopolis. I got that right today? All right, cool. And Doug?
Lane.
Delaney.
Yeah. Lane is my last name.
Oh, just Lane? Okay, I know it. I see it printed a couple different ways, so my bad.
Lane is my DJ name.
Okay, my bad. So anyhow, these guys have put on this Spindependence here in Champaign, and we're going to talk a little bit with them about kind of how they grew into that role and how they became kind of co-workers and partners in crime to get this thing going. So, Doug, let's talk a little bit about your background, like how you started in DJing and music and how you got kind of the bug for performing live yourself way before the promotional aspect came involved.
For me, my brother was a DJ, and my father loved music, so I've always been up in turntable at the house and records at home. Like I said, my brother was a DJ, so I kind of followed him. My brother's my idol, he's 7 years older than me, so.
Now, was he any good?
My brother never played out.
So okay.
He was DJ, but he did it at the crib and at house parties in New York and whatnot. So he didn't really play out. He didn't play clubs or anything like that. I idolized my brother. I used to sit down and watch him in the basement. He had a little turntable set up. And I used to watch him DJ when I was a kid. And then eventually when he stopped, I took all his shit. I took all his records. And took my dad's belt drive techniques back then. Obviously fucked those up trying to scratch. That was it. That was just my love started. You know, bought my first turntables, by mowing lawns my freshman year in high school.
Some of your earlier records or influences that, you know, like the genre that kind of, when you started going live and started getting the maybe more gigs, more back-to-back, what kind of atmosphere was that for you?
I'm a hip-hop head, man. I've graduated to a lot more. My knowledge of music and obviously as you grow has expanded and things I love changed as I've gotten older and whatnot, but I was purely, hip-hop. I was, you know, my cousin, the big DJ, Rasta Roo, in Atlanta, and he actually taught me some over the phone. I was using GangsTA. I want to say maybe even my students maybe. I can't remember. But, I was hip hop.
Actually, that's going to steer us left just for a minute. Give us an example of that, because now I'm curious how that works.
How it works?
Yeah,
maybe
talking about BPMs or in key songs or stuff like that.
Yeah, he didn't teach me anything about key, and I'm actually not even that great at that now, to be honest. I didn't know how a mixer worked.
So just give me the basic concept.
Just basic concept, how to blend. I learned blending first. Still not that great expression, to be honest. So he basically taught me, you know, two records, taught me to get doubles and learn how to, you know, he actually taught me how to blend using the same record. That was my first one.
So I heard you say Chicago earlier when we were talking about kind of your influences getting started. Are you from Champaign?
No.
Or did you, where when you're talking about those early years?
Yeah. Born out east. I was actually born in northern New Jersey.
Alright, so how'd the path to Champaign happen?
Nutshell version, my pops got a job in Chicago. He was commuting for a couple of years back in New York. And me being the youngest, after my brother and sister left the house, I came with my parents to Chicago. I came down here for school, and I never left, essentially. I don't really consider Chicago home, so there was no reason to drive me to go back up to Chicago, even though my folks were there and whatnot. I wasn't going back out east, because my folks were here.
Yeah.
So I just stayed here, man.
Yeah, which is nice. I mean, I've been here 5 years myself and love it.
It's great. I got a degree in architecture, which I don't use anymore. But I came down here, I went up to Chicago for about a year, and I came back down here just because I just didn't want to do the 9-5 anymore. It's not for me, and I knew I could make money down here again, so. But I didn't. 12 years later, 15 years later.
Nice. Well, we're certainly, the community's better for it, so thanks for both of you. How'd you find each other in this community and start to grow together to get to what we now have as Spindependence?
I think we officially met. He was DJing at a place called Tumaine, and then for a while, I think that's when I officially met him, and I didn't really know him that well.
Were you working there at Tumaine?
No, at that point I was working on campus, but then I had just, soon after that, opened up that place, Barfly, and I remember grand opening, him and the GM, and Lisa came in with a bottle of blue. Remember that? And that's how I got it.
That's a good sales pitch, yeah. So, did you guys just kind of like start to forge kind of chemistry within the community as years go by? Or
I mean, I think our thing was really organic, right? Like yeah, it wasn't yeah. like it wasn't planned. Like we yeah, sit yeah. down and say, hey, we should do some stuff together. Like it was really organic. Cosmo has been a huge influence in this community.
Sure,
long before I got here. And then I was doing my thing, and you know, and I wasn't really connected too much to the community at first because I was connected to the university.
Yeah.
So my major draw was the university skills. And then I started coming downtown and doing stuff downtown, and then I think we just naturally grew together because we're kind of the same.
Yeah, like, I can't even remember like the first thing we did together. It was just like we were always doing things, and doing things in the community, and yeah. eventually our
just crossed
and started working together, and it made sense.
Yeah, well, it clearly does. Obviously, you guys have together and individually both very good influences. John, of course, you said. You know, Spindependence kind of started, and then it paused, and then it started again.
Yeah, we brought it back together.
I was going to say, was the reboot, that was my question, was the reboot part of you guys getting together and saying, you know, we have something here, we need to really grow it a little bit better?
Yeah, I mean, essentially, I think you guys might have talked about this already, but he started with Spindependence originally. Then it was a break, it was just a low, because I don't know why.
Yeah.
But whatever, and then he had asked me at one point, yeah, I think we were talking and we just said, hey, let's bring it back. And I was like, yeah, I'm down, let's do it. And then I think we just found out we were going to
go. Yeah. I think originally, you know, because at that point, yeah, I wasn't working in Boston, I was working for Red Bull.
I was going to say, did that influence in your experience with Red Bull maybe kind of give you a better insight on how to get something like this going?
Possibly, because I mean, my job at that time, before switching to the role, was working a lot with music events and festivals. And that probably inspired me.
Yeah.
Some of the events and just the experience as well. But then I think that the reason I reached out to Doug was because I knew that he had a lot of influence with his following in the DJ community and people that wanted to check this stuff out. So I figured that'd be a great, you know, I had my crowd, he had his crowd, it was a crossover.
Yeah.
Together we could,
yeah. Just like the community, the DJs, everybody's just this big group hug. And it's a great thing, and I think it's extremely unique for us, and it makes me proud to kind of live here. So what aspect of that do you most cherish when you see like how positive and supportive everybody is?
Just that. I don't think I've been to a city that, I mean, maybe I'm stretched, but there's not many cities that have this sort of vibe with all the DJs. Everyone, you know, is helpful with each other. There's a lot of cities, and it's really antagonistic. The scene is all love.
Yeah. I think if it wasn't that way, it wouldn't be a DJ community here. The scene wouldn't be as good as it is now, because I think that's what makes it grow. That's what makes it strong.
And this event wouldn't work.
I mean, we just recently started bringing in outsiders from Chicago and other markets. I mean, we actually, hey, like all the DJs that are performing, 95% of them are doing it for free.
Yeah, exactly.
And they can't wait. Like, if we don't post something a month out, like, when is Spindependence? We want to know.
Now to kind of wrap up a little bit on your side, Doug, what advice, because a lot of the YouTube channel is good for me, but a lot of the people I talk to and a lot of people that are watching are upstarters, maybe some young kid in his bedroom trying to figure out, you know, not so much how to mix, but how to get his foot in the door. I hear that question all the time, like, what's it take, what's it going to take? So what would be your advice to a young kid that's trying to, maybe he's got some skills and he's just trying to figure out a way to get exposed?
When you say foot in the door, do you mean like, what, gigs? Or?
Yeah, just gigs in general. Like, what would it take? What would be your advice to a young kid that's out there somewhere, probably has talent?
I mean, here's the thing nowadays, man, as opposed to when I started, and I'm sure probably say the same, there's so many DJs now.
Yeah.
Because it's...
Yeah, the digital age is really flooded.
Technology's been good and bad.
Yeah.
Exactly. Back in the day, there was a lot of DJs, but I mean, it was something that cost a lot of money to become a DJ. Took a lot of time,
a lot of research.
Yes. You didn't have, you weren't just going, getting online and downloading songs or registering and whatnot. So I think nowadays there's so many DJs, so I think the only advice that I give people is you got to find your voice, you know what I mean? Because how do you separate yourself from every other person? I think you probably talked about that a little bit when I walked in. You got to find your voice, man. I mean, but, you know, there's all kinds of DJs. Sometimes you need a DJ who's going to play the hits, and there's times for that. I'm a DJ who I can do that. I can play the hits, or I can play house, and we can come the same way. The old school, it can be whatever the environment is. But I think you got to find your voice, man. And that's the thing. And you have to, you have to find your voice, and you also have to be diligent about what venues you're going through and asking to DJ at. And be good at your job. That's another thing that people don't get. I mean, listen, you know, you're doing your DJ somewhere, bring people.
Yeah.
Right?
That's my biggest frustration. Yeah. That's my biggest frustration. I don't get some of the people who are DJs for a living. During the day is the time that you need to be hustling and marketing yourself, reaching out to clubs, reaching out to venues, reaching out to people to promote your night and yourself. Yeah. It baffles me when a 21-year-old DJ is DJing and three people show up.
Yeah.
I'd like to say a man of a certain age, and I can put out one or two, you know, a little bit of effort and get 50 people to show up.
Yeah.
How does a 21-year-old person get three people to show up? That's
shocking. I mean, event production, curation, promotion now, that came from me DJing and needing people to come to my bar, right? So I would promote the hell out of it and get people drunk, and then that came secondary, after DJing. But yeah, you bring people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If you're going to get a job, bring people, and that's how you build your
following. No, nobody's going to hire you again if you bring people.
For you guys listening, that's the promoter speaking to you right now. The DJ spoke to you, but now that's the promoters. Of course, have that influence and by all means champion yourself. And guys, that's pretty much it. I just want to say thanks for taking time out of your busy schedule through the week here and do this for me. It means a lot to be part of the weekend with you, and thanks for you sharing your time. So,
thank you. No, we're not doing it together.
This is going to be my
head.
Nice. Yo, check it out. Big shout out to Martini Lounge. Make sure to share, subscribe, and like.
Share Martini Lounge.
Thank you very much. We appreciate you.
You just wanna spell fire in the sea, come ride in the sea.
trash girl, she a lie on the seat. She a fart on the seat, now she jogging on the streets. I'm a trash girl, one, thinking like a fan, asking for a pick. You cheat, you phone call, who are you, who are you? You think I don't know, you need a lift. If you is or is, you ain't got that money. No, I owe you or debit cards, I need cash money. Now I need you to slow down, it's not the risk now. I can't really hear what you gotta say now.
Start it, ho.
It's on the spot.
I'm